Hello viewers and learners, I extend a warm welcome to the present module on Course Management System and Tools Part 3. With today's greetings, I am Professor Naseeb Singh Gill from Department of Computer Science and Applications and Director, Digital Learning Initiatives and Monitoring Cell of Maharshi Dayanand University, Rohtak, Haryana. Learning management systems and course management system are becoming vital part of classrooms in the 21st century. Looking at its importance, we already have discussed in detail the popular learning management systems and in-depth understanding of the modules on course management, learning content management system, learning management system in the previous two modules. In the last module, we have discussed at depth one of the very popular open source learning management system, that is Moodle, and that stands for Modular Object Oriented Dynamic Learning Environment. Apart from this, there are several more learning management system which are also very popular among teachers and learners, which include Blackboard, Google Classroom, Canvas, and more importantly, another, that is called SWAM. Ministry of Human Resources Development, Government of India, has also launched its own learning management system, and that is called SWAM, SWAYAM, which stands for Study Waves of Active Learning for Young Aspiring Minds. SWAM is an Indian electronic e-education platform which offer courses from the high school stage to postgraduate stage in an interactive electronic platform. This present module is aimed to get learners a practical exposure and orientation of the two learning management system. These are SWAM and Google Classroom. SWAM is an instrument for self-actualization, which provides opportunities for a lifelong learning. Here, learner can choose from hundreds of courses virtually. Every course that is taught at the university, college, or school level. And this shall be offered by best of the teachers in India and elsewhere. If a student is studying in any college, he can transfer the credits earned by taking these courses into their academic record. If you are working or not working in school or out of school, SWAM presents a unique educational opportunity to expand the horizons of knowledge. SWAM also gets the flexibility and opportunities to the students as well as teachers. They can register for different purposes, and for which you also have to have an exposure. With your practical orientation of Moodle, it is very easier for you to get on hands-on experience on SWAM learning management system without any difficulty. Further, you as a participant of this online refresher course on SWAM MOOCs might be already well versed and acquainted with the entire functionality of SWAM learning environment as a student. Now, to get you the practical orientation and exposure as a student or as a teacher, you may join me this practical live session. So friends, welcome to the practical session on SWAM learning management system. First of all, what you have to do is you have to open up your browser and you may look for our this website, stamp.gov.in. Or what you can do is, you can also search this website on Google and click, here is the register option. If you click it, it will ask you to fill in certain information. And what it will be? If you say, if you are a new user, you have to sign up now. If you already have account, then you are not required to. So what you have to do is, give your username, your generate your own password, confirm the password, provide the email, and then what? Send verification code. Our verification code will be sent on to your email. And here you have to put in your surname, your given name or display name. And after this, our this create button will be enabled. So after this, you will be creating the account. So automatically, what you will get your SWAM account. After this, what you have to do is, you have to log in. And here, if suppose I've created my account and I'm just going to the password and you are logging in. It will take you to our this SWAM portal. Observe here carefully. What it shows, all courses. So is candidate can enroll into different courses. Here is the dashboard. If you are finding what exactly you mean by the dashboard, this is the dashboard which is open. And what it shows? It shows all your activities. Just like this is the dashboard, and that is showing for our this December month 2018. If you look on this side, it shows your my courses. Because since you are currently enrolled for one course, that's why it is showing your only one course. And what is the course? You can come to know after you press over this button. And this is the course that you are enrolled. It will show you. This is the course. That is Pedagogical Innovations and Research Methodology. And here it shows the details of the course coordinator, Professor Dr. Vandana Punia at Gurudev University of Science and Technology, Hisar. So this is the current courses you are enrolled. Let's come back to our first option, all courses. You can choose any courses you like for which you are eligible. And it will show you the different courses. Here it shows you a long list. So what you can do is you can search this particular courses and you can select. Come to the dashboard. It is showing you over this dashboard. Have a look at. It shows the recent conversation. Recent conversation with the different participants on this particular course. This is what. These are different messages which are popped up in this particular window. And this is here the concerned teacher who will be responding to the different queries of the different participants. What it shows? It shows these are different schedule that is showing under your due soon. Similarly, you could also recommend our different courses. If you want to have a look at our this particular dashboard, it can show you what exactly is scheduled this week. If you press this week, it will schedule that on during 16 to 22nd December. This is a pedagogical innovation schedule that has been shown here on this particular date. If you want for the particular day, is there anything scheduled today? It is Sunday. There is no schedule. If you want to have a look at the list, it will show you the entire list. That is your Pedagogical Innovation Research Methodology Assignment 7. If you want to have a look at what is the available in the dashboard as your schedule. So on the left side, if you find what are this, it shows the assignment. If you want to see the article, it will show you. If you want, what the different video sessions available. So these are the video sessions which are available and which have been shown in different colors. Documents, if you just check over this button, it will show you. So here, corresponding to different colors of the legend which have been listed here, you can select anyone. For example, if you just would like to select what is scheduled on 24 December, if for example if you click, you will be able to see the video too. And in the video, and what you will be shown, you will be shown this particular video which will be scheduled on, and what you can do, you can play it here. For example, if you just play it, you will just find it and it can show you the entire full screen window.
Hello viewers and learners,
you can again go to different options
to on collaboration and communication tools.
If you say again, moving on to your different activities, let me take you to the different options. Here is my calendar. You can have a look at this is a calendar, and calendar can be scheduled for different days of the week, for a specific day or the entire month. It's very important option here is my progress. If you move to this option, my progress, it will show your progress. And on this side, left side, you are noticing is a course overview. So it shows the brief details, the course view for which the students have enrolled. So what the total days, there's a course duration 118 days, and this is the enrollment date, this is the content progress, this is a teacher name, bottom one is student grievances, that will show you about the different teacher grievance number, title, created date, category, acted by, and these are the different details. Because in case what kind of issue you want to report or submit, it is just showing you, and you can scroll down accordingly. If it doesn't belong to any of the categories, you can go for the others. And once you submit, it will also show you the submission date, the date created, and here status. If for example status is yes, then you can also have a look at our this report. If you are just looking at our student notice, this is the marks or grades that if once available, it will show you in the window. Similarly, our student course progress, as already indicated, that has also been bar charted, and that is also has been shown as the overall progress. Apart from this, this is also other details that you can update your profile. If you want to change our this language option, that is also available. If you want to search anything, this is a search button that is available. This is the overall calendar that you want, that you can look at. It will be showing you month wise, or if you just want to switch to any of the previous months, then it could also be again changed. For example, October, November, or anything accordingly. If you want to switch to any of the options, is a month, is a week, then it will be shifted to the week or day or the list. It will show you the entire list as here. So I hope it's quite simple, and you would have got most of the things I just demonstrated in this live session. So with this brief session, I hope that you will be able to enjoy our creation of your own SWAM account, and you can register for the different courses. And you can also visualize your overall progress, and you can enjoy all the different activities which are scheduled by the particular teachers as well as under different courses. This was all about our brief session. There are several more learning management systems which are also very popular among teachers and learners. Our practical session on very popular learning management system, that is Google Classroom. What you have to do is to switch on to Google Classroom. You may search on the search engine, that is your Google Classroom. So what do you find? Here is the option. If you go to Google Classroom, switch to this option, then it will require you to sign in. If you have already created your account or not, if you have created your account, you can log in. If it is not, then you will have to sign in. And accordingly, you will be taken directly to the Google Classroom. For example, if you are already having our Gmail account, just like in case as I do have, what you have to do is you have to sign in. And as I am providing, I'm just logging in my account. You'll be taken to this panel where it shows these are the different classes you as a teacher have created. More importantly, when you haven't earlier created any class, here is a button that is available. What it shows? It shows create or join a class. So this option can be used by the teachers or students. By the teachers, if you press this button, it will show you join class. So it is meant for the students, because students have to join the class of a teacher. Who will be creating the class? A teacher. So teacher is responsible for creating a class and providing the respective code of the class to the students who can join. Only after they are provided the class code. If you look on this side, this is showing classroom main menu. If you press this button, this is a main menu it could be showing. And on the main menu, what it shows? Calendar. It shows to-do list. It shows the respective classes which have already been created. Now, let me demonstrate to you that as how a student can join a class and how a teacher can create a class. Let me press this button. Create class. This is the normal generic instruction you are supposed to go through. And once you have gone through this instruction, it means this is meant for how to use classroom at a school with students. And if you say continue, what it will be? It will be requiring you to fill in this information. Class name. For example, I am writing here MCA 5th semester. I am writing section. Suppose there is only one section. It is section 1. Suppose it is a subject. If I am saying it is software testing, this is the name of the subject. And here, suppose this is the classroom. And if you say, if you just press this button, create, it will take few seconds. So it is in the process of creating the class. So remember one thing, when you are as a teacher creating a class, each class you create, you will be provided a specific code. And that code you have to provide to your students. So in this case, when you have created, okay, MCA 5th semester and section 1, this is, you have been shown who created. So what you can do? You can share something. If, for example, if you are interested to send some message, if, for example, if you write, attend to the seminar, if I'm just putting in this message, at 5 p.m., if I'm saying, if you want to attach something, you can attach. If you want to save the Google Drive, or you want to attach our this particular YouTube or some other attachment messages, so accordingly you can do. And this once you say, is your post, it will be posted. So you as a teacher have posted it. And it will be sent to all the students of your class. What it shows on this side, left side, upcoming. Any upcoming activity, it will be shown here. Here, if you observe on this side, I just indicated, this is showing, if you have a look at, this was the MC fifth semester class we just added. We can add on to this to-do list. We can also add on to the different calendar. For example, if you say, what exit the calendar, it will be showing you. There was today's date, 16th December. And what you want to schedule throughout the week, it is up to you to decide. This is the option, what is available today, what will be next, so you can accordingly go for. If you just want to go for your particular, any of the other settings, you can enjoy. In case, if you are interested to join as a class, as a student, what will be required? You will be provided a particular code by the concerned teacher. For example, certain code you have provided, you have to enter and you can push this button, join. Thanks a lot, learners, for enjoying this module as well as for your active participation in this module. Thank you very much.